name's Grace King. Higgins is going to receive to start the game, going from left to right on the screen.
One of our strong points has been our kickoffs because of our kicker, Eric Hackler. He's a kid from Hungary. He's a soccer player. And again, he kicks it to the five, but then they get a good return on us. We've really been haven't gotten, we've held people around the 30 most of the year, and two times they broke it past.
Well, that was a big plus for us because we knew that Grace King had a good kicker, and we were able to really practice, you know, against our kicker, John Patipinta, who does the same thing as far as kicking well. It's Laurie Tate on the 32 dive.
Higgins starting with excellent field position after the kickoff return.
Again, we're going to mix it up right and left, give it to one back, give it to Mark, give it to Lloyd, and see what the defense is like and play it, you know, somewhat conservative right now. That's Aaron on a catch.
Good coverage. Good coverage by Chad Phillips. He's a real dangerous receiver. He gave us a lot of fits last year.
Good throw by Chris Johnson there. That's Lloyd Tate on a inside via to that side. He cut it up, and then he was able to go ahead and break it for a score.
Of course, that was the score that we were speaking about, you know, at the beginning of the show.
Yeah, at that point, you know, the confidence level really increased. I mean, you know,
yes.
you would at times think that it would bring us down and all of that, but I thought and felt, you know, especially being on the sidelines, the confidence level really, you know, increased and gave everybody that opportunity to believe in themselves. And like Coach Barnes always says, focus on what they're doing so that they can go ahead and have positive things.
Well, I think that showed, too, the way the whole first half and the entire game was played.
Yes.
There was a replay of that touchdown, and early in the first quarter, Higgins goes on top 7-0 over King. We have 9:57 left in the first quarter.
That was John Patipinto kicking the extra point. And like I say, he's coming back from that hip injury, and he's still doing an outstanding job.
Well, they did a good job of going. We were keying on Addison. We knew we had to stop him. They do a lot with him. They did a good job of running the fullback at us. And still, I mean, we have keys on that to stop it, but they did a good job going to an alternate back. The key here was for us to establish something offensively. The last couple games, teams have scored on us. We've come back and had to go 1-2-3 kick. And although we don't score on this drive, we do get a couple first downs and help change the field position, which is going to help us in a few series here. And this is one of the reasons we wanted to run this week, because last year Higgins did an excellent job of stopping our belly play, which everybody and their brother knows we run, but some people can't seem to stop it. But Higgins did a real good job last year, so we said we're going to have to go outside with the sweep. And this is Joe Marshall on the sweep behind the two guards, 67 Mike Perdue and 57 Christian Murillo. And Joe's our outside linebacker, probably one of the best defensive backs. He doesn't outside linebackers. He doesn't get to run the ball much, and we've alternated him in good. But this is Russell Thompson running the belly and cutting it back.
Yeah, so that was a good run by number 20 there. He was able to go ahead and find his hole. Defense is still swarming by the ball. They're just missing tackles.
Coach, I noticed you dropped 42, one of your linebackers, into the line on that series.
Yeah, so we know that they run the belly and they run other things, you know, that kind of worried us. So we kind of gave him a six-man front and changed it up a little bit. And Leonard was a very fast and strong athlete that we were able to put down and give him a little fits. And like a few plays before, it showed because he was in on a tackle behind the backfield.
Here we are getting 3 and 4 yards, 4 and 5 yards, which we'll take, you know, in a sweep. We don't have the blazing speed to break it. If we'd still be running the same offense, we'd just be different. We'd be breaking a few more, but we're getting 4 and 5 yards and a clip here. And can't have a negative play or a zero play when you're doing that. And sometimes, and I think they step up here and they stop us and we try to run a little option over here. Now, we're not an option team, but we put it in because we run the belly so much, and I think he could have rode the option fake up in there a little bit more. And they did a good job covering it.
Yeah, again, the defense is, you can see them all around the ball, 4, 5, 6 different blue jerseys there, and they swarm into the ball, and at this point in the game, they're playing real good defense.
This was a good play on their part, because I thought we were going to complete it, but number 10 comes up, makes a good hit.
That's Kai Dunn. Kai, you know, later on in the game had one or two little mental breakdowns as far as coverage goes, but at times Kai's a very sound ball player.
Grace King facing a fourth down at the Higgins 25.
That's Corey Cryer, my converted tight end, who's playing offensive tackle and now defensive tackle. Corey has really stepped up and kind of gave us a lot of confidence so that we were able to go ahead and do some positive things.
Higgins taking over with 4 minutes left in the quarter. And Coach Hitchens, you were a little out of field goal range there on fourth down.
We were right at it. Right at his, he had been making like 40 yards before the game. We were right at his average there. And I just didn't really want to try it back then because I wanted to keep the field position. And I thought we, you know, try to keep field position. I thought we needed seven more than three at that time.
Yes.
And still here, we haven't stopped, and they're going to Addison here.
We're changing it up, right. We're just changing it up. We're giving it to Mark the first play. We gave it to Lloyd. Then we're giving it to Mark. So we're just changing things up because both of them are having a real good day.
Well, we needed something to turn it around here because, look, here they go 4 and 5 more yards. And, as far as them being flat from the victory before, they come out real strong.
Right. The offensive line, again, you know, has been really stepping it up and playing well. Lloyd Taylor on a good block, throws a little bit high there. But Corey Cryer, Lawrence Allen, Lance Daniels, Chris Thompson, Larry Jackson, boy, those five have really, Barrett Sanger time, Leonard Bridges has really stepped up and played well. His mark on the outside, unfortunately, we had, you know, it's really hard to go ahead and have great things happen or good things happen and all of a sudden take points right off the board. And this is a case of it here where you get a holding penalty.
We thought that we were extremely fortunate there that they got the holding call because the next play we get this, the two plays later, we're going to get a fumble recovery. And that will go from 7 points to us getting the ball back.
And as coaches, we know, you know, penalties, you know, really, really hurt more than anything else, especially when they take the points off the board.
It's a good play by Benji Zamora, comes up from his corner position, and Brad Phillips hustling to get the recovery.
Grace King takes over after the fumble recovery with good field position here late in the first quarter.
That was the turning point of the game right there, I think. I mean, as far as the first quarter goes. Right. There was other momentum shifts, but this is definitely one because it could have been 14-0.
Well, as you mentioned that, this is a game of momentum shifts. It'll always sway back and forth.
Real good pass from Chad Phillips to Brad Phillips.
Yeah, the two brothers
drag
there.
Pattern.
You know, I've been watching them in track and wrestling and whatever, and I mean, the two brothers really get along well, and boy, it's nice. It's got to be nice to have two fine athletes
well,
on the team.
Their enthusiasm is just unmatched. They really just they're on go all the thing, all day long, they're on go. I mean, just always fired up. And
I know, just from being
I just wish the only problem I just we didn't have to play them both ways because they'd really excel at their positions. Little counterplay to Thad Carter. He's doing a good job. We were able to alternate quite a few backs in. And so we kind of did running back by committee. This is Benji Zamora. Probably for the first time this year has been completely healthy. He's been nursing knee injuries and little minor things. He had a slight shoulder separation, so he was really full strength this time. And his little sweep back to the left, to the right, to Brad Phillips.
Grace King now at the Higgins 15-yard line.
They're on five on the tackle there.
They run a bootleg play here and catch a tight end open deep, Eric Burgess. He really came to play this ball game also. He's, in fact, came to me before the game. He normally is our backup punter and asked me if he could catch a few passes because he says, Coach, I've been struggling with my passes. That's a good idea. I just want you to go over there and catch a few. And he had dropped one the week before against Eric, and we went big time. But he came through with some big catches here.
Here's a replay of that touchdown.
Real good fakes by the backs and carried out the fakes and good bootleg action by Chad Phillips and also Christian Murillo on the block there, hooking the end.
With 10:22 left in the second quarter, it's now a tie football game. King Higgins, 7-7. And, you know, running to the left, throw back to the right, that's a difficult pass to throw, too.
Yeah, it is. He's been fairly consistent with it. And then we're really fortunate we're able to complete it, and they come back and they get another good return. And I'm still concerned defensively here because we really, the fumble stopped them, and we hadn't stopped them yet, and they're going to come down here and have another good drive.
Mark's ready. Mark, you know, came to the sideline, said he's ready to go ahead and take the ball. We ran a little option, and Chris read the play well and came back and you know, did some positive things there. Unfortunately, though, we had penalties on both sides.
Two penalty flags on the play.
And it still came out to where, you know, we were hurt, but we weren't hurt that bad because King had a penalty also, so it kind of put us back into the field.
Well, they marked off the holding penalty first and then the personal foul penalty, which actually gave you a net 5-yard gain on the play.
Correct. Right. Personal foul penalties never help you.
Right.
Never, no matter when they happen.
Mark on the toss there, and he's... Mark does, you know, a great job reading the holes, and he can get 5 yards of pop as long as he reads the holes, and that's what he does here. You know, blocking up front is again good. This is a lead play, and offensive line's doing a good job. People making tackles 5 and 7 yards down the field.
Well, I think, as you mentioned, you know, the offensive line for Higgins has matured greatly, you know, over the course of this season.
Yeah, so they've really has played, you know, with nothing but improvement in the last 3 weeks.
That was a good play there by Ryan Delpino. Was at the football quite a bit. His quickness kind of gets him in trouble sometimes, but he was around the ball a lot at the game, and also Jason Giroir came up, the free safety came up real strong.
His little middle screen there, the linebacker read it well. Everybody was there. I think it was a little confusion on our line's part, unfortunately. And allowed the linebacker to come in.
That was Kevin Florrick, 51 on the play, and George Nassar, 77. Kevin just came in. He was playing offensive tackle, and he came in for that play, and fortunately it was a good move. He was able to read the screen well.
Lloyd Tate at this point is really having a good game. We're able to go ahead and run inside veer, just giving the ball right now. You know, at times, Chris does a real good job reading it, and he knows that the little hole's open for a second, and Lloyd's fast enough to get to the hole.
They caught us on here with call here on the unbalance. They caught us on a bad adjustment. We adjusted in the second half. It's helped us out a bit. But
again, Chris Johnson on that, you know, did that. That was all on his part. Able to give, and then he comes back, knew that they were going to come back inside and read, so he took it outside. Mark was still outside for the pitch, but Chris was able to get it in.
Here's the replay of that touchdown.
And this is, they did a good job. They set us up with an unbalanced one way and came back with the options of the other way. And we had adjusted to the unbalanced and they had people there, but wrong people on quarterback, wrong people on the pitch.
Now that's a point right now in the game where, you know, the confidence thing I was talking about earlier, you know, you get that quick score, but the offense knew that they were able to drive the ball back down and able to come back and get that ball in. Kids had a lot of confidence, a lot of positive influence as far as what they were doing, and as everything developed, kicking, special teams, defense, everybody was real positive and confident.
We have 5 minutes left to go in the first half, and Higgins has now taken the lead 14-7. And coach, I can agree with that, because, you know, once you get that momentum, you know you can move the football, you know, it leads to good things.
We got within an inch of breaking that for a long run there, and a little sophomore running back return man got in front of the other return man, and it opened up in the middle, and we were about to break it, and he kind of slowed him down, but we were able to still make something positive here.
Here's the defense, you know, really hunkering down and trying to do positive things and play well, and coaching them came up with the pass again. And
excellent catch by everybody. He was open quick, and then they underthrew him, and then he came back to the ball real good to make the catch.
I was off the ground. He caught it 6 inches off the ground, so that was a very good catch right there. And again, they caught us sleeping, and they were able to get behind us. It's a good thing that the pass wasn't a little further, because they may have got it for a score.
That's Chad Phillips there. It was a good hit. He took a hit to the stomach, got the wind knocked out of him, but he hung in there to throw the pass, and they would come back with a sweep again.
Now, who's the quarterback that came in to replace
him? Oh, this is Joe Bergman. Joe Bergman came in for he's got a lot of playing time this year. And one of the reasons we've done that is for situations like this. He's, like I told you, never know when you come in. He comes in and handles, runs three plays here without a problem. In fact, completes a pass.
Right.
In fact, he came off the sideline, you know, and he said, how about that pass? It's a pretty good pass. He's not bad for being cold. And I said, he did a good job. And he says, well, that's what I'm here for. A little pass and a real good run by Joe Marshall.
Very good. That was Alfred Cross, Channing Warner, Leonard Kaufman right there on the tackle. That's Channing Warner making the initial hit. not mistaken.
We keep telling them to hug that guard, that even though it doesn't look like anything's in there. You might get three or four one time. Next time, you might break it even more to hug that inside guard.
Shot
Tennessee don't want to get wide.
Yes.
This is a real good surge here about offensive line with a quarterback sneak, and if he didn't have it, he knows it right there. If he hadn't fell to his knee, he would have scored because he had good surge there about an old middle of the line.
Grace King now moving deep into Higgins territory late in the second quarter.
We were running behind Kevin Florey playing his first game at offensive tackle, left tackle, and we're running to the left behind Kevin Florey, 51, and Christian Murillo, 57. Then we run to Belly again.
Grace King now with a second down on the Higgins 4-yard line.
And then we go in with the Belly again to the left, and Joe Marshall with an excellent lead block on Russell Thompson filling the hole, and also a good turnout block by Eric Burgess. And so that was right for a half, and that's what I was glad that I told him when it was 14-7, we had a good drive. It's just take your time, because we were having a little trouble stopping them. And so this was a good surge here.
And there's that replay of that touchdown. The point after was good. We have a minute 14 left in the first half. Tie football game, 14-14, Higgins King.
And here we are trying to make something happen on the kickoff, and we get a great block by Mark Addison. Aaron takes it to the sidelines and gets very good positive yards right here out of it. Offense again comes on the field very confident, knowing that we're able to go ahead and maybe get something happen and maybe go for a field goal towards the end.
Excellent field position for Higgins. And again, coming back with that option play that was successful in the last series.
That's correct. And Chris just had a small little, a hand came out of the grass and tripped him up. And it's a shame that happened. Here's we're running out of time, and we try to get the ball down there.
That was good because, like we mentioned earlier, trying to keep them in front.
Yes.
Because we didn't want to get beat deep. They burned us a few times. I've seen them burn quite a few schools this year on deep pattern. Good gang tackling, and I think we made some adjustments at halftime. We had a few simple things that we weren't doing with our front four that had been successful for us most of the year, and we still made some changes at halftime that helped us.
That brings the first half to a close. King 14, Higgins 14. It's my understanding that that this young man did not know anything about the game of football when he first came over here.
Well, and he still has a lot to learn about it because right at that kick right before halftime there, I went and told Eric Roberts, who's a graduate assistant, who's a real good kicker for McNeese State and also a Grace King graduate, and I went and told him, I said, in your best Hungarian, tell him how to squib kick. And so I told him on the kick before, don't kick it to 25. Or they had two good ones back there, but I said, don't kick it to 25. 11 wasn't much better, but I mean, I was more afraid of Addison. And so when he came out and he kicked it straight down the field, I told a couple of coaches, we're going to squib kick this one. So I told the defensive coach, let's get ready. We're going to squib kick it. And he ends up kicking it deep, but it was a good kick. And like I told him, I said, thank goodness for you, you made the tackle, because they broke it down the sideline, and he was able to step up and make the tackle. But we'd picked him. I'd gone and watched a soccer team play a few games last year and was wanting to pick up a kicker and watched him play. And he's a real tough kid on the soccer field. And he was kicking the ball like 50, 55 yards. And so I think we could use this. And so he was also, I talked to him. He said he was going to play. And then he happened to be in Coach Cliff Cotterman's PE class. And he was kicking field goals in PE class, and Coach Cotterman comes up to me and says, I think we found a kicker. And I said, what's his name, Hackler? And he was kind of disappointed because he wanted to discover it. And I said, well, no, that's good. I'm glad he's been kicking. But no, he's done real well, and he's adjusted to the game, and it's also helped having Coach Roberts, a graduate student, work with him, a student teacher work with him on his kicking and things and the parts of the game. And he still got a little bit to learn. but he's doing fine.
I think that we get a lot of our kickers now, you know, from soccer teams, more and more, you know, the soccer kickers are the ones that are doing it in high school football. A great first half, you know, a lot of exciting plays, a lot of good offense, both teams, you know, moving the ball well, both teams coming up with big defensive plays. 14-14, you've got to be going in, you know, thinking that you're doing a lot of things right, but again, trying to make a few adjustments for the second half. I know, Coach, you mentioned right at the end that you were looking at a couple adjustments to begin the second half.
Well, I felt real fortunate to be in the game 14-14. They had a touchdown call back, and they've moved the ball. The only time we stopped them was on a fumble, and fortunately, our offense was able to move the ball real good and control the clock. So offensively, we made very few changes at halftime, but defensively, we were, again, got on our front because I didn't think they were making their initial play, their initial reads and initial contact on the offensive lineman because they were getting a lot of people through on our linebackers. So we wanted our front to get back to playing where they know how, and then that would help our linebackers. Our linebackers are extremely young, and they make a few hustle mistakes, I like to call, because they run and they're all over the place. Which I like to have is speed at linebackers, but I think we had to get our front to tighten up a little bit, and plus Coach Bobby Cate made a few adjustments on that option play, which is we'll see it helped us in the second half, which we'd gone over, but it was just misalignment on our part, and we were trying to get them to see it, but they caught us real good with that.
And Coach, you know, 14-14, but as Coach mentioned, you had one score called back, could have easily been 21-14 Higgins. Offensively, of course, you had to be pleased. Defensively, maybe a few adjustments at halftime.
Well, offensively, we set out what we planned to do, and that was to go ahead and put points on the board and run Mark and Lloyd a whole lot, let Chris throw the ball, let him run his option. So everything was working, and, you know, it's always a knife in the back when you can go ahead and take points off the board. Defensively,
sure.
We came back, and, you know, we had some adjustments to make. Kids were playing a good game, but we did have some adjustments to make because, we really didn't stop Grace King a whole lot. I mean, they were just running right and left, throwing the ball, misdirection, play action, and, we felt that it was very hard for us to go ahead and read the wing tee and at the same time, you know, defend everything.
Yeah.
Coaching them did a good job with the offense that they had, and I thought the defense, you know, had some key plays and all, but Grace King had more of the key plays, and they were able to capitalize on them.
Well, I think both teams did an excellent job of mixing up the play calling, you know, running inside, outside, mixing in the pass, keeping the defenses off balance in the first half.
Yeah, it was very, as far as offensively for us, we definitely went inside, outside, giving it to one back, giving it to the other back, letting Chris run it, throw the ball once or twice, and, mix it up. We saw that the running game was good, give everything a big opening, and the passing game would be open later on, and so we stuck to it. Defensively, as we defended against coaching them, they mixed it up real well, and I think that's what threw the defense off, not only looking at the backfield, what the wing tee, but mixing it up definitely gave us problems, and, it was one or two plays that really, like I said earlier, they capitalized and did some very positive things.
Let's take a look at the second half highlights. Higgins, Grace King. Higgins kicking off to begin the second half.
I was real happy to be able to get the ball. This is Adam Louder, number 10, making a good return here. He's a senior, and he's a real good role player for us. He'll fill in at fullback, halfback, wingback, return, defensive back. He really helps us out, one of those players you need to fill in spots like that. So here we come. We're going to go back to what had been working. So I didn't think we had to make many changes on offense, just run our offense. And
at that point, we've made some adjustments, and you can see that we're starting to bring linebackers up more. We're trying to get onto the outside more. We put Chris Thompson in a tackle, 77 there. And, and for a while there, you know, we started to control a little bit of Grace King.
Thompson,
and give him
Thompson
some
made
tough.
A real good play on that because I thought we had it blocked out in front. And I thought he came from behind and hustled and caught the quarterback.
Yeah.
I was a little disappointed in that because I always think our bootleg is we always say it's like another running play. You know what I mean? Although it's a pass, you got to complete it.
Right.
And that was one of the only few bad plays we had on offense. I thought we should have connected on that one. That was Thaddeus Carter on a real good one. We needed a good play on a kick return. That was a good job on his part getting down there.
Was Walter Evans in on the catch there. Earlier, you know, defense came out and we were able to make them punt. And, I mean, we put pressure on the quarterback, I think, that rushed the pass and gave us that opportunity to come back, get the ball, and, again, let the offense have their confidence. And here we are, you know, going straight back into the running game. We're going to run the ball. We're going to change it up here and there. We're back in our regular offense, not in the unbalanced. Unfortunately, here's one of those negatives I always talk about to the kids. We had an offsides penalty. And kind of stopped the momentum a little bit. We come back, we give it to Mark. Mark does a good job reading, breaks it outside, and gets positive yards, gets a first down right there.
Very, very dangerous runner. He did a good job of looking at the original hole and bouncing it outside. He stuffed the inside hole, and our bounce guy, we call him, went there to make the play.
Here's the inside again. You know, offensive line's just, you know, turning out. We lead blocking on linebacker, and we're having some good things happen there.
But this play, we thought we'd bring our linebackers, bring a little pressure.
Yeah,
I don't know if that affected it or not. But,
yeah, that was a trap play. And offensive line-wise, if you look at it, it was blocked well. If we get the ball, Law is able to take it straight up the field. But we had a messed up snap. I think the linebackers blitzing kind of stirred us up a little bit, and that's what happened.
It's a real big play for us, because this type of play usually hurts Grace King, and Joe Marshall reacted to it real good and made it, didn't make the tackle, but then we had like four or five people jump on top of it. And I thought that was a good play call on their part, because that's the kind of stuff that hurts us.
Higgins punting the football on fourth down, unable to overcome those penalties in the Grace King defense on that opening drive of the second half for them.
I thought we should have had that block. If we'd extended, we'd have gotten it. I kind of really thought we had a man right there on the kicker, and again, he went more toward the kicker than where the point is in front of the ball. But he did rush him to make him to mess up the kick. So we got good field position here.
At this point, you know, here we are trying to play offense, defense, but at the same time, we're also playing against the refs. And, you know, it becomes a problem when you start losing the mental game. And now you not only have to worry about defense and offense and, you know, what you're going to defend, but now you got to worry about, you know, making the mental mistakes that's going to cost you big plays and stuff. And you allow the team to get back into the game. And right here, Grace King does a good job as far as knowing they're back into the game, capitalizing on things, and, you know, being very positive with everything.
All right, compliments the quarterback sneak there, but for the first down, but I'd like to compliment Bobby Ledoux on his offensive coordinator, and he does the play calling during the game, and I thought he did a good job staying patient with the offense and not jumping out there wanting to throw. And, you know, he picked his spots really well with
right.
The passes. I thought I have to give him a compliment for that. Also, Cliff Cotterman did a good job with the offensive line, because I think our offensive line play has improved, and that was one of our weak points due to graduation this year. This is Chad Phillips trying to make something go on the outside, and he's going to learn. He's not going to get much out there.
Ron
he gained
Lewis
four or five
tackle.
Yards, but against Higgins' speed and team speed we play against, you got to cut the thing up behind the guard, even if there's nothing there.
Grace King moving to the Higgins 9-yard line.
That's Russell Thompson on a belly play to the left.
Even though we made the adjustments, I still felt that we were doing some positive things. But like Coach said, you know, they had some, you know, from Bobby, they had some great play selections. And Coach Hershey, was calling the defense. And the play selections and the calling the defenses, the offense and defense, it was like a chess game, like Coach Bowen says. And, you know, what happened was that they were able to go ahead and move King to whatever, and they were able to capitalize with a touchdown.
That was a big, big play, because we had like three or four decisions to make on that. Whether the kick, we had an excellent field goal kicker, but we had fourth and one, and we're debating on a belly or a sneak or kicking the field goal. We decided to go ahead with the, because we were getting good block on the left side, and I was just wanting to get the first down, and when he got in the end zone, it was just an excellent plus, and that was a good run. He's reading the belly good, and good blocking on the left side again. Kevin Florick, Eric Burgess, and Christian Murillo. Jason Armand doing a good job at center also.
The point after was good. We have 2:56 left in the third quarter. King going on top, 21-14 over Higgins.
Coach Bridges here with the special teams. He had a right return there, and you know, he does a great job with special teams and all. And you know, the kids were really pumped up about getting the ball back and being able to go ahead and give the offense that opportunity to go down the field. And the kicker just came out and had a fabulous kick to like the 2-yard line.
A real good kick by Eric Hackler again. And we end up getting a personal foul penalty here, which was not pleased with because it put him back on the 35. We had him, we finally get a kick where we got him on a 20.
Yeah, we're going to run a little unbalanced there, and we're going to run to the unbalanced side with Mark Addison, making a great effort, getting 2-3 yards a pop. They got us for a little illegal motion.
I think our defense will respond a little bit better this start now. We got the 7-point lead. Now we're starting to run to the ball, making a few adjustments. They're still running hard, getting 2 or 3 yards, but we are getting to the ball now, and they weren't just breaking free.
And again, we're sticking to the offense and going left, going right.
Good play here. Brad Phillips comes up and turns it in like he's supposed to with George Nassif coming
up. Yeah, we missed a block on the outside there. And boy, you know, like I said, the defense came up. We're able to turn him back inside and get somebody on him.
Jason G-Rock came up on that play. Brian Delpino, a little sophomore linebacker, stepped up big. A real close measurement here. I think it was fine. And I thought it was a good spot. I mean, I know a lot of people on the King side didn't think so, but when I'd say that, I thought the kid had got to the line of scrimmage and got to the line. And so it almost was a bad spot for Higgins, but I thought they'd gotten it.
Higgins held Grace King on fourth down, taking over.
Lloyd Tate right here. Here we are trying to run a little pass play, and Coach and them came up hard on the outside, had 2 or 3 people there. We were going to swing it out the mark, and they covered it well. And at the last minute, Lloyd was able to go ahead and pick up the linebacker that came outside, and Chris got, you know, some positive yards here. We come back with this, you know, formation again, and we're going to roll out to the right, and we sent back Aaron on the backside post, and Chris just overthrew him there. Wide open, just overthrew him.
Here we get a good positive return. This Brad Phillips on the return.